5 passing habits you need to develop. We're going to keep this pretty short and simple and succinct. That's coming up next. Before we get into the first one, which we're going to start with number 5, so going in reverse order, make sure you get my program Passing and Receiving Mastery if this is an area you really want to gain mastery over. You can get it at a huge discount now down below in the description. So without further ado, let's get into the first one again, starting with number 5. Number 5 is, for the most part, keep most of your passes simple, low, and on the deck. You know, the amount of times I see players with a simple pass elevate it or cause it to bobble because their technique is off, we're not just talking about the pitch here, like I've seen this happen on turf fields, for example, is too many to count. And it's lazy passing, just swinging your foot at it, just trying to get the ball in the general direction of your teammate without really thinking. If you notice, the pro players, a lot of times they're not doing this, especially if they're playing a simple pass to a player who might be under pressure. They want to play it crisply on the deck because they want it to be easy for their teammate to control it. If it's bobbling or it's in the air unnecessarily, they might need to take a little more time to control it. They might have to play it back when they wouldn't have needed to otherwise. So make sure you're keeping most of your passes, most simple passes, on the deck, nice and smooth, so you're not making it unnecessarily difficult for your teammate. Number 4 is another very simple one, but it's make sure you're putting the right amount of pace on the ball. Again, the amount of times I've seen a player, and I've done this myself too, many times when I've hit it too hard or too soft, but I see it all of the time. Like again, a simple pass, but it's too soft and it allows either the opponent to get a foot in or even to close down your teammate when, if you just played the right pace, you know, your teammate would have been able to turn, would have been able to face up their opponent a little better or take the first touch into space. So make sure you're putting enough power on the ball, but not too much. I've also seen players blast the ball into someone's feet unnecessarily, you know, not because they're in a pocket of space and they need it blasted to get there, but they're like, there's no one around them and they'll just blast it into them and it makes it just so hard to control, or it'll be at like shin height or something. So make sure you're learning what amount of pace to put on the ball. That's going to come from practice, being in these situations, but please make sure you're not hitting it too soft or too hard based on the situation. Another important habit to develop is understanding when to play the ball into your teammate's feet versus play it ahead of them. And this is crucial because the amount of times, usually what happens, this is the mistake I see, is the ball needs to be played ahead of your teammate so they can run onto it and stay in stride, but instead it's played behind or even to their feet, and so they have to stop, you know, control the ball and then take a touch in that direction. You need to know and also have the skill to be able to play a little bit ahead sometimes when the space is there for them to do so, but there are other times when the space isn't there, or if you do that, you'll be playing it into an opponent, or simply your teammate is calling it to 2 feet, that you need to play it into their feet. So understand the difference, understand the situations where you need to play it ahead of them. Usually a lot, for example, it might be a winger is making that run, they have plenty of space, or maybe an overlapping run from someone and you can play into that space for them to run into, and know when to play it into feet. It's a simple distinction, a simple difference, but it can make a world of difference based on what you do. Number 2 is a little more nuanced, and I don't want to say a little more advanced because you can be a beginner and start thinking about this, but play it to the right foot. Now, I don't mean the right foot over the left foot. I mean the correct foot. You know, if your, for example, teammate needs it played across their body to their right foot so they can face forward, make sure you're doing that instead of, again, playing it here so they have to turn around and then bring the ball back this way just to face forward. But in the other situation, maybe they have someone who's rushing onto them and they need it played to that back foot so they can shield the ball or potentially play it back. So you do need to think about which side you need to be playing the ball to when you're passing it in these simple situations, because again, if you play it to this foot and it takes them more time to turn when they would have had the chance to, they might be closed down or the options available to them might close up. But again, if you play it to this foot and an opponent can maybe stick a leg in or they're too close, they might lose the ball, or you will lose the ball actually in that situation. So you would need to play it to their back foot so that they can shield it, potentially turn or do whatever they're going to do. But start understanding which foot to play it to. It does actually make a difference. And a lot of times it's just a lazy pass if you're not thinking about this or keeping this in mind. You know, even simple passes I see, you know, play to the foot that's not the most advantageous in the situation. So start thinking about this because again, even with 5-yard, 10-yard passes, this can be very important. It's a very nuanced thing, but it is crucial. Again, football is a game of inches, a game of milliseconds sometimes. So the millisecond it takes to turn when it could have just been played to the other foot does make a difference. And number one is simply practice many different techniques. Obviously, this is more advanced. If you want to work on this, also get into the course I recommended, Passing and Receiving Mastery. Again, you can get it for like 10 bucks, I think, right now. It's on a super discount, so you can get that down below. Full video course, training program, everything. So if you're looking to work on these areas, but learn different techniques. Because yes, for the most part, you're going to be doing simple side-footed passes, maybe use the outside a little bit, but most of the time you want to use the inside just for accuracy and technique's sake, keeping it on the deck, trying to not get too much spin on it. But you also want to know how to put spin on the ball, use the outside to bend it around an opponent into space, how to use a grass cutter pass, a long lofted pass, because sometimes you'll be in a situation where you need to instinctually use a technique, and if you haven't practiced it, well, you're not going to be able to do it well. So make sure you're working on these other techniques. Make sure you're working on the simple ones first and foremost and getting really good at those, but make sure you're also working on other techniques in your training so that you can call upon those techniques instinctually in matches when you need them. All right, everyone, that's been 5 passing habits you need to develop. Again, we kept this pretty succinct and short, so you can just go out there and start applying these things. Once again, get my course, Passing and Receiving Mastery, if you want more help with this and you really want to get this area down. Again, huge discount right now through this video if you want it. Anyway, thank you so much for tuning into this video, and I'll see you in the next one.